another major health threat. This one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
I began to get into iodine a few years ago because it was helping me and my family so much get healthy and detoxify. Most people know that iodine deficiency has been a crisis around the world. Iodine is key to so many of the body's functions, especially the thyroid. I discovered a product being developed by Dr. Group. You now know it as Survival Shield, true nascent iodine that your body can really absorb. Then, about a year ago, he said, listen, if you think this is powerful, I'm going to come out with rare earth, deep earth crystals. And the results that I personally have been life-changing. Nobody else has got iodine based on these pure crystals, ladies and gentlemen. This is innovating, and the best part is it helps fund InfoWars.com, the radio show, the TV show, the whole media operation promoting true libertarian ideas.
For a limited time, experience the ancient power of Survival Shield X2. Take advantage of this unprecedented 30% off super detox special at InfoWarsLife.com.
General, what do you think about the FBI saying that there's a terror alert on Monday about a potential Fort Hood situation?
The police are shoving people, shoving Alex, shoving the crowd.
Here we go, folks, I'm being assaulted.
Whether it's the radio show, the news websites, documentary films, or the nightly news, InfoWars is the tip of the spear.
Is this another false flag stage attack to take our civil liberties and put more homeland security by sticking our hands down on pants on the streets?
It's up to us to set brush fires in the minds of men and women everywhere. And that's what PrisonPlanet.tv is designed to do.
You watch, the Assad regime is going to be blamed or accused of using chemical weapons against the so-called rebels.
What we see now is a war against reality. It's a war against the truth.
It's more vital than ever that supporters of freedom become members of PrisonPlanet.tv and share their membership with up to 11 friends and family. Visit InfoWarsNews.com today. Become a member, share your membership, and help take the InfoWar to the next level.
In the councils of government, we must guard against the acquisition of unwarranted influence, whether sought or unsought, by the military-industrial complex.
I hereby declare this to be an unlawful assembly. I order all those assembled to immediately disperse.
It's a military mission in North St. Louis. Heavily armored vehicles are rolling into town.
And don't be alarmed if you see those over the next 7 days rolling through your neighborhood.
If you see military helicopters flying low over Minneapolis, do not be alarmed.
The guns will be taken. No one will be able to be armed. We will take all weapons.
Mr. and Mrs. America, turn them all in.
Just really brainwash people into thinking about guns in a vastly different way.
Enough. 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 Enough.
The Department of Homeland Security is apparently on a huge ammo buying spree.
It comes out to like 1.6 billion rounds of ammunition.
And as KSLA News 12 Jeff Farrell discovered, the clergy would help the government with potentially their biggest problem. Us.
So part of it is we have to break through our kind of private idea that kids belong to their parents or kids belong to their families and recognize that kids belong to whole communities.
If you got a business, that you didn't build that. Somebody else made that happen.
Mercury-containing vaccines may help, not harm kids, according to two new studies in the journal Pediatrics.
Black Hawk choppers soaring through the night sky, but this is only a drill.
Heavily armed officers in Watertown search for the suspect, house to house.
It's a joint military training exercise involving local police, also military.
In your apartment!
I am in my apartment, sir.
Go back inside right now!
I am inside.
I have two words for you. Predator drones. You will never see it coming.
The dramatic scene played out in front of our cameras. Parents grabbing their children and running after spending the night hunkering in their houses and then finding themselves face to face with the muzzle of a SWAT officer's rifle.
They let them in the area. They told them they could come in, and now they're coming in like they're trespassers, punching and shoving people.
We're not turning our guns in, and we're not running, and we're not backing down. If you want them, come and take them.
The march. The Empire is on the run. Live from the Infowars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
The potential for the disastrous rise of misplaced power exists and will persist.
This is the heart.
We're back live. I am going to try to answer that caller's question in about 10, 15 minutes when Joe Biggs leaves us, and continue with calls right through the entire next hour with a ton of breaking news as well. This just broke at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Instead of monitoring ISIS, Obama spied on Americans. Former Pentagon official reveals president has been given granular intelligence on the rise of terror group for over a year, meaning almost none, reports Judge Andrew Napolitano. You also have former top general McErnie coming out saying, quote, we helped build ISIS. ISIS is Al-Qaeda under a new name because our government and others were embarrassed over openly arming them to attack Syria. Our own military said no last year. This time last year, it was epic. Thousands of tweets with photos of officers holding signs over their faces saying, I will not fight in Syria for Al-Qaeda. General Dempsey went and said, no, we're not going to be part of it. It was a real moment of America finding its soul again, finding the moral capacity to say no. We voted down carbon taxes. We voted down having open borders. We voted down more gun control. Now Obama just does it by executive orders. So the good news is people are waking up. Humanity understands we're in a crisis. Congress has a 7% approval rating, but the establishment doesn't care and is moving forward. So it's the immovable object running into the unstoppable force. It's an epic time to be alive right now. That's why all you-know-what is breaking loose around the world. It's not just here. This is a key time to be alive. Now, the heat out there is really raising havoc on our equipment with our live Skype feed. Our equipment's been overheating, so I'm going to go to them. It may cut out any minute. They've been posting HD reports every few hours to Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com and to the nightly news tonight, 7 o'clock Central. Joe Biggs, staff reporter, along with our top graphics guy and cameraman, Josh Owens, out there on the border in El Paso, where DHS last week said imminent terror attack on or before September 11th. They believe against Joint Task Force 6 at Fort Bliss. Biggs has a lot of Army connections there. He was a staff sergeant that got out about a year and a half ago from the Army. So he has a lot of connections down there and at Biggs Field, named after his grandfather, a great-grandfather. So, Joe, you're down there. You've got the intel. You've got a lot of breaking information for us. Is this a real threat, or are they getting ready to false flag, or is it just hype, or is it people leaking memos who want to draw attention to the fact that our border's wide open? We know thousands of other than Mexicans or other than Latin Americans, as they're called, are coming across just there in Texas every month, according to the Border Patrol's own internal documents. So what's the real intel, Joe Biggs?
Joe Biggs here with Infowars.com in El Paso, Texas. And like you said earlier, Alex, this is an epic time in history that we live in. All the stuff that's going on right now, it's just mind-blowing. You know, the things with Russia and Ukraine, our southern borders are wide open. We have this imminent threat by the ISIS terror group in Juarez just behind me. You know, This is crazy. We funded them. These guys, they used to be ISIS, then they became Al-Qaeda in Iraq, and then they've gone back to ISIS now that Osama bin Laden is dead. You know, these guys are brutal people. They chop people's heads off, they crucify them, kill people in mass numbers. You know, the fact that the commanding general of Fort Bliss was sat down and briefed about a possible ISIS threat, that says a lot. You know, my friend is his driver, and here's a lot of the things that goes on, and they take it as a credible threat. I spoke to some of the locals here. They think it's a credible threat as well. A lot of them said that they won't even be anywhere around this area come September 11th. You know, and now we have these 11 missing planes out of the Libya airport that's been overrun. You know, crazy. We're almost, you know, approaching our 13th anniversary of the 9/11 attacks. We have all this stuff going on. You know, Al-Qaeda put an online magazine that states they want to hit the Air Force Academy. They want to hit a military academy in Georgia. They want to hit Las Vegas. And once again, New York is another target as well, Times Squares. So these are very trying times.
And they now have 12 passenger jets in working order and have been photographed celebrating with them, basically saying they're going to kill us with them.
I mean, either way, even if it is a false flag or if it's real, this is something they're going to use to take our liberties away. Plain and simple. We saw how easy martial law can be in place in Ferguson. Everybody saw our live streams, our Ustreams, our videos that were put up for 2 weeks straight. It was so easy overnight for that to happen. You know, everything that's happening in the world right now is a step forward. We're moving inch by inch closer and closer to this complete and total domination. They're going to strip us of everything that we have. And it's scary to be in this time, but it's also a historic time in our lives.
Well, without giving up too much about sources there at the base, and of course, they're not telling you anything they're not supposed to tell you, but you talked to your friend, he said, no, we take it very serious. The Joint Chiefs had a planned meeting September 11th in New York. They canceled it 2 days before, back in 2001. Mayor Willie Brown told Condoleezza Rice not to be in New York that day, San Francisco Chronicle. Anybody can look this up. So bare minimum, when you get told by one of your sources that, no, they don't even plan to be on the base on September 11th, and you're also telling me they've sealed the base down to two entrances, is a huge base, and that all this is going on, they're taking it serious.
Yes, you know, and as with the Pentagon as well, you know, how they had moved a lot of people away from that area as well where it was struck. So that's kind of a telltale as well. You know, like you said, the two main bases, they have the Sergeant Major Gate, which is at Biggs Field, and they have the Biggs Entrance. Those are two main entrances where there's a lot of high-ranking people, and they close those down. They left some of the other little smaller ones open where they go into worried about it. But right behind me, if you remember, there's a spot down here where we had filmed where the gate was left wide open. I think the Border Patrol has begun to watch our video. They now have, there was two vehicles earlier. They have one vehicle posted up right now. But last night I was given some information by a lady who's lived her entire life. She's about 35 years old. And right down on the this main strip of I-10, there's a huge part of the fence that's completely knocked over. So I'm going to go over there and check that out. But, you know, I've talked to some people, and people are like, oh, it's crazy. You know, El Paso is very guarded. It's the second safest city in the U.S. There's no way that ISIS could possibly get through. Well, the thing is, though, is if we created ISIS and we run ISIS, we're going to give them the tools they need to succeed. They're a big propaganda weapon. This is
what's to stop them from driving a dump truck full of explosives right up there to the base?
Exactly. And people are like, no, there's no way. There's no gaps in our border. Well, I'm going to take Josh here in a minute to a lot of spots. I know this town very well. Well, just right over here, there's no fence whatsoever. It's the river, and there's an American flag and a Mexican flag right there. And you can walk. There's no fence whatsoever. Just on the other side of the dirt line, there's a store. Last time I was here, there was a guy sitting outside with a sombrero on, just hanging out. That's U.S. You could drive across that. The road leads.
You ought to do what Project Veritas did. Go to a costume shop, dress up in a jihadi outfit, and just wade across it. It's like 2 feet deep. Man wades across as bin Laden in ISIS attack zone. I mean, just to illustrate to people that, okay, if it's a real threat or a fake threat, regardless, stop groping us when we fly, stop the highway checkpoints looking randomly for Al-Qaeda. it's ridiculous. Stop hardening shopping malls and police departments when you won't even control the border. It's like, leave the gate open, but then have the guards pointing swords at people that live inside the city. It makes absolutely no sense.